Here's such a writing of
introduction to research paper do a lot of work. It may seem obvious, but introduction are always placed at the beginning of the paper. Your reader from a general subject area to the narrow topic that your paper cover. They also explain your paper. What is the scope? Scope is actually the topic you will covering. So we also see the context in the introduction, and the context is the background of your topic. And we also discuss importance. Importance means why your research matter in the context, like scope, industry, or the word you are introduced will cover a lot of ground. However, it will only on half of a page to the few page long. The length depends on the size of your paper as a whole. In many cases, the introduction will be shorter than all the other sections of the paper. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel and also hit the bell icon for watching the more video in this area. A question in mind arise, how should I structure introduction? Can I use subheading and introduction? Generally answer the following question. You can use the answer to this question to structure your introduction. And question are, what is the problem? Are there any existing solution in the literature? Which solution is the best? What is its main limitation? What gap I am hoping to fill? What do I hope to achieve? Have I achieved what I set out to do? If your introduction is more than a couple of pages, subheading will be make it more better and more digestible for the reader. So keep point in this mind while you writing the paper. What is the length of your introduction? Now, next question arise, why is introduction vital to reach the paper? Introduction vital to reach the paper. Introduction, your research paper is just important, it's critical. Your reader do not know what your introduction will come. In a good introduction help your reader understand your topic background. It also explains why your research paper is worth reading. Introduction also offer a guide for navigating the rest of the paper. Pick your reader interest. Without a clear introduction, your readers will struggle. They may feel confused when they start reading your. They might even give up entirely. Your introduction will ground them and prepare them for the in-depth research to come. What should you include in introduction for your research paper? So, introduction are always unique. After all, research is originally definition. However, they often contain six essential atoms. These are, number one, overview of your topic. Narrow the overview until you address your paper specific subject. Then mention question or concern you have about the case. Note that you will address them in publication. Number two, prior research. Your introduction is a place to review other conclusion on your topic. Include both older scholar and modern scholar. This background information shows that you are aware of prior research. It also introduces past finding to those who might not have experience. Is rational for your paper, explain why your topic need to be addressed right. If applicable, connect it to the current issues. Additionally, you can show a problem where the former theories are reveal a gap in current research paper. Before you do it, a good rationale will interest your reader and demonstrate why they must read the rest of your paper. In your paper, describe the methodology you used. Recount your process to make your paper more credible. Lay out your goal and the question you will address. Reveal how now you conduct research and describe how you measure results. Moreover, explain why you made key choice. And in your introduction, a thesis statement, which is the main introduction, should end with a thesis statement. This statement summarizes the ideas that will be run throughout your entire research article. It should be straightforward and clear. And you will also make the outline. Outline introduction often conclude with the outline. Your layout should be quickly review what you intend to cover in the following section. Think of it as a roadmap guiding your reader to the end of paper. These six items are emphasized more or less depend on your field. For example, a physics research paper might emphasize methodology, an English journal article might be high. Three tips for writing introduction. I don't just want you to learn how to write introduction for your research paper. I want to learn how it makes it shiny and beautiful. There are three things you can do that will make easier to write a great introduction, and you can write your introduction last. An introduction summarizes all the things you have learned from research paper. While it can feel good to get together, prefer done quickly. You should write the rest of your paper first, then you'll find it easy to create clear overview. Include a strong quotation or story up front in introduction. You want your paper to be full of substance, but that doesn't mean it should be feel boring or flat. Add a relevant quotation or surprising update to the beginning of your introduction. This technique will pique the interest of your readers, leave the wanting more. Next, be concise. Research paper cover complex ideas. To help your reader, try to write it clearly as possible. Use concise sentence. Check for confusing grammar or syntax. Read your introduction out loudly to catch awkward phrases. Before you finish your paper, be sure to proofread it. Mistake can be seem unprofessional. Include quotation or story up front. How long should be introduction be? It's also a question. There's no definite answer to this question. Find the most cited paper in your field and note the proportion of space to give the introduction relative to the other section. Adopt the same proportion. I have noticed that the longer the introduction in relation to the rest of the paper, the lower the level of innovation. Often authors write a huge introduction to hide the fact that they have very little to say about its actual research. Reviewers are aware of this trick. Think about introduction in other area of life, in a term, in an oral presentation at conference. Would you want 8 minutes of introduction in a 20-minute TV interview with a famous personality? Would you want 10 minutes of introduction before the personality even utter a word? I know that presentation and interview cannot be directly related to research paper, but the basic idea is that both viewer and reader want to same thing. So keep this point in your mind. How should I begin my introduction? It consists of sequence of 10 parts, each with a specific role. your introduction will not necessarily include the part, time or not. Sequence them in the same order. Your aim is to include only enough background information to allow your reader to understand why you are asking the question, you are in what context they appear, and why your hypothesis, prediction or expected result are reasonable. It is like a preview to the rest of the paper. Thus, nearly every introduction in respect of the discipline would incorporate those part marked with asterisk. Part 1, definition of topic plus background. This introductory phrase may not necessary in your paper. Here is a definition of XYZ battery indicate that the reader that this is the background topic, the general context of the paper. This is a place to include notation, technical definition, and explanation a keyword. The second sentence gives information that readers should already be familiar with and suggest why the topic is important and of interest. It will help reader understand why you are investing this area and how you hope to extend the knowledge. It sets the context for the information that will follow. It may be less familiar for your reader. Reader want to quickly learn what the specific topic of your research is. They are much less interested in being remain how important the general area of research is. To accept state of the art plus problem in the example, like XYZ battery is the general context. The author now move from this general context to the specific area of their research in this example. XYZ battery is in the telephone, and more specifically the problem inherent in such battery. This is a gap that the author want to fill and that the reader should be most interested in. This part state in simple and clear language exactly what is the problem and why you choose it. So I hope that you have understand the concept. Now I would like to share an example of the introduction. An example is, and children, entire school teacher play important role in shaping children experience outside of the home environment, and early on can assist in supporting your children adaptation to new challenge and demand during the transition into classroom environment. So it's a very lengthy sentence, but it gives the complete information. Aside from the formal role of teaching academic skill, teachers are often responsible for regulating activity level, communication and contact with peer. Oh, so this is also a statement which gives some background. And here they have also gave the citation Hoover and Helmut in 1993. One Mathewin and Helmut. Teacher also provide behavioral support and teach copying skill. So we have cited Dahl 1996. Now we have to give an opposite idea in contrast to parent. Children relation between teacher and children are more likely to the time linter in nature. Yeah, teacher-children relationship are deemed important to children of all age. So we have take the opposite idea. So this is the example of the introduction. I hope that you have understand what is the concept of interview, how introduction, how to write the introduction, what are the part of introduction, and I hope that you will feel comfortable to writing the introduction of your research paper.